pacing back and forth. Oh, I don't understand why you're standing right here. All your shots have scored. No, scratching at the scars you left on my-
Hey, what's up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Faze, and if you're new here, I post weekly vlogs, makeup tutorials, hair tutorials, and anything beauty related. So today I'm so excited for you guys to watch this video. I made a makeup brush review. I bought these awesome brushes from Legit, and I just wanted to try them on camera just to show you guys how they are in case you guys are interested in buying them. This video is not sponsored, but I really loved their brushes. They're so cute, you guys. I was just instantly like hooked on them when I saw them, so stay tuned. So before we even start this makeup look, I want to show you guys this amazing case the brushes came in. You guys just look at it. Like, I feel like I can even put like other brushes and like my concealer and my pencil in it. It is so cute. So these are the brushes. I haven't used them. I honestly haven't used them because I wanted to do the review. Like, I wanted to do an honest review on camera. So I haven't used any of them. I think there's a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh, there's 10 brushes. I actually didn't know that. So there's 10 brushes in total. I want to do like a simple look so I can like make an honest review on them. So yeah, they are so cute, you guys. Just look at this. Look at this, you guys. Look at this. Just look at that. Like, what? First things first, we are going to do our eyebrows. I'm just going to comb them with this brush. It came with this pencil. I also bought it at Legit. It's actually new. Next, I'm going to go in with this. It's like an eyeliner pencil. So this one is great for beginners. It's $35. City Girl eyeliner pencil in the brown shade from Edgar's. I totally recommend it. So yeah. So after tracing the bottom, I'm going to trace the top. So after that, I'm going to go back with this one. This one is the brown one I used earlier. I'm just going to fill it with this one because it's a lighter shade than the one I used to outline. You want to go a little harder at the ends and then go lighter here to give it a nice ombre kind of brow. After filling it in, I'm just gonna brush it, like quickly brush it to make sure everything is filled in, no spaces. Just brush it. So this is what it looks like. It's just a normal brush. I guess I wanna see how the hairs work on my eyebrows and like concealing and everything, but like it's okay, the grip is fine. Yeah, so far so good. So I'm going to be going in with this Cool Design concealer. I also bought it at Edgar's. It is so affordable. I forgot how much it is. Oh, it's $30, you guys. It's super affordable. I bought it at Edgar's. They don't always have it, but you can totally check or just take a number of one of the salespeople there and then just get it, you guys. Trust me, it works. quickly do the top part of the brow. So before I quickly blend everything out, I just want to give a quick review on this brush. To be honest, I feel like it was too fluffy for an eyebrow brush. Maybe it's because it's new, I don't know, but I might give it another try off camera. But on a scale of 1 to 10, I would say it's a 6. Honestly, it's an honest review. It's a 6. Honestly, it's a 6. And if you can actually look close, the brush hairs are actually coming out, which isn't a good thing because I paid for these. So it's a 6 out of 10. So that is not a good start, legit. Come on, it's not a good start. But yeah. So next I'm going to do my foundation. I know a lot of people usually go with the eyes, but I like to do them at the end because I just prefer it that way. So I'm gonna do my foundation really quick. So the foundation I'm going to be using is this Estee Lauder foundation. It's a double wear same place makeup. I don't really know the shade. Oh, it's the shade Rich Cocoa. I had no idea. It's the first time I'm actually even seeing that. So I think this one retails for like $600. I bought it in SA, but I think you can find it at Woolworths. I'm not really sure about Clicks and Edgars, but you guys can totally check it out. It's really good, but I would say you have to know how to blend because it turns orange as the day goes on. But yeah, apart from that, it's full coverage. It's perfect for people like me because I have scars. It's really, really good, so you should totally get it. Let's put on our foundation. This is the brush I'm using. They don't really have sizes on them. I think it's just a normal brush, I don't know. So yeah. You guys, I'm really worried about these brush hairs. They keep sticking out and I feel like they're gonna fall off. I feel like the brush is really pretty, but when it comes to like actually working, just a few problems. So I'm done with applying my foundation, and honestly, if it wasn't for the brush hairs, I would give this one a 10 out of 10, but like they keep sticking out and it doesn't feel really good on the skin. But apart from that, it is an 8, I would give it an 8, I loved it, I love the grip when I'm applying my foundation, I loved it, so I'm going to give it an 8 out of 10. Next, we are going to conceal our under eyes, the nose, the chin, and this area. I'm also going to put some on my eyelids because I'll be applying eyeshadow later. So let's go. I'm applying the design concealer I showed you guys earlier. It's the same one. I think it's only one shade lighter. So you guys, I usually blend this out with a blender again, but I'm going to use this brush again because I'm doing a review. But okay, this one doesn't have as much hair sticking out, which is good. It smells kind of good actually. Let's blend this concealer out. You guys, this one is actually also really fluffy, which is nice because it's not like totally hard on the skin, which is nice because you don't want to put something that is hard on your skin, especially when you have acne prone skin like me. It can easily get irritated if you're scratching your face, so this is nice because it's really 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 fluffy and soft. So we're done with blending this out. I think this brush was my favorite. It didn't really give me that many problems, but because there's always room for improvement, I think I'm going to give this one a 9 out of 10. But I really liked it. I don't even know why I'm giving it a 9. I think I'm just going to give it a 10. A 10, yeah, this one is a 10. To bake my face, this is the brush I'm going to use. It's also really soft, which is something that I like. So it's also fluffy, which I think is going to apply my powder very 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 well. So yeah, let's get on with it. I always make sure to put extra powder on my T area because it sweats like a lot. I think this one was my favorite brush that I've used today. It wasn't super harsh on my skin. I loved it. It worked perfectly, so I think I'm going to give this one a 10 out of 10. Up front, like, I'm not even kidding, like, this one is a 10. These are the brushes that I left. I think I'm going to use most of them on my eyes. You guys, I usually buy most of my palettes at ID. I feel like they have so many shades, but you can totally buy them at Edgar's. I've seen some really cool ones lately, but then I wasn't interested in buying them. But yeah, I'm not really sure about Clicks. I feel like at Clicks they usually have the small ones that come in like ones or twos. The eyeshadow brushes actually work way better than I was expecting, so I'm quickly going to conceal my inner eye. I think that's what it is. Yeah, so I have like a nice kind of cut crease look, so I'll just do that really quick. Usually don't do crazy looks on my eyes because I wear glasses, so I cover my looks up anyway, so I don't really do anything crazy. So I like to keep it simple, so I'm just gonna quickly do this. It's like a glittery kind of nude. I haven't really used it before, so I'm excited to see how this is going to turn out. So I'll just dip my brush into that. So if I'm going to give a review on all the brushes I just used on my eyes, I think I'm going to give them a 9. I like them, but I feel like there's always room for improvement, so I think the 9 is perfect for them. I'm going to apply my mascara on this eye before I move on to this one really quick. Now to complete the look on my on this eye, I'm going to use this mascara. It's my Envy Lash mascara from Estee Lauder. It came with the foundation. I think I got this for free because I bought a lot of stuff, so it's really good, especially for me because I don't wear fake lashes. Now for the last brush, I think this one is the last brush that is left in the set. It's this, like, it's just a normal flat top kind of brush. I'm going to use it to apply blush just to complete the makeup review. Apart from that, I don't really apply blush on a regular basis, but I will today. So yeah guys, so I just finished applying my blush with this brush, and I think I'm going to give this one a 7 out of 10, just because it is not a blush brush and I feel like it's kind of small because it didn't really cover my cheeks, so I had to go back like multiple times. But other than that, it was kind of nice. I'm just going to apply my setting spray just to set everything in place because I still have a long day ahead of me and I don't want everything to be a mess. Before I make a full review, I'm just going to quickly apply my lipstick. It's a purple kind of dark shade. I think it's from, I don't really know the name of the shade. Oh, it's the Rocker 647 Rocker shade. It's from MAC. I think I bought it in SA. I don't really buy most of my stuff here because I feel like, no offense, but I feel like people here are so rude. I feel like they just look at you and they feel like, ah, this one can't be buying like expensive lipstick or expensive foundation in there, and they just brush you off. And I don't like that because I really like makeup, so I just quiet whenever we're traveling or something. And it sucks, you guys, because sometimes you really, really want something and then they just look at you like you're crazy and you're like, I want to buy something. Like, whatever. But yeah, so I'm just going to go in with this lipstick before I make full review on everything we talked about today. So that completes my look for today, you guys. As for the brushes, I love them, I love them, I love them. I think I'm going to give them a total average of an 8, and then the case is a 10 out of 10, no doubt. So thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you liked it. I loved, loved, loved filming it. Thank you, thank you, thank you for tuning into my channel. If you like this video, make sure to subscribe, subscribe, subscribe. It helps me out a lot because I know how many people love my content and want to see more of it. Like it, comment anything down below. Some of you have actually brought important things to my attention in the comment section. So also comment down below what you want to see me do. I always, always, always appreciate. And I try to reply to the comments as much as I can. So thank you so much.